Good morning to all. Welcome to the virtual class of computer of class 8. Today we are going to start lesson number 8. Our topic is looping in QBasic and project handling. So let's start. Looping. Looping is repeated execution of certain steps for a fixed number of times. This controlled repetition can be achieved by following steps. First, initialization of control variable like count equal to 0. Second, statements to be repeated forming body of loop. Third is incrementing the value of control variable count equal to count plus 1. Fourth, checking control variable against final control less than final. If condition is true, control goes back to the body of loop. If condition is false, control moves the next step. Statement number 5. Display loop over. And in the last of the program, end. For next statement, the process of looping can be simplified with the help of for next statement. This single statement has all the three steps required for making a loop, that is initialization of control variable, condition checking with the final value, incrementing and decrementing control variable. For next is best stated when some statements are not to be repeated fixed number of times. How for next works? When control comes for for statement first time, the initial value is assigned to the control variable. Statements given between for and next are executed. Next statement increments the value of control variable by 1 and shifts the control to for statement beginning of loop. Value of control variable is checked against final value. If it is still less then or equal to final value, the statement in body of loop are repeated. If value of control variable exceeds the final value, the control shift out of the loop and statements given after next is executed. Next is project. Any work which has a specified aim and has to be completed in defined period of time can be carried over like a project. Every project has certain characteristics. First is, every project has a defined objective or goal or aim. It consists of sequence of tasks and subtasks. Every task has a specific purpose and is clearly defined. The project has a defined timeline according to which its task should be completed. And in the last, every project has its time limit. Project management cycle. A project will be successfully completed if we follow the steps of project management cycle. A project management cycle consists of following steps. First is identification and planning. The main aim of the project is defined and planning is done to achieve the aim in a defined time period. Coordination and organization. Proper coordination of all the activities is done to complete each task in time. Finally, the tasks are compiled to get the final project. Next is implementation. The project is executed after compiling all the activities. Next is monitoring. The tasks are supervised thoroughly so that the activities are running properly. Next is evaluation and testing. All the tasks are evaluated and tested properly before finally executing the project. Thank you.